Hi, my name is Marzia Niccolai, and I'm a developer programs engineer here at Google. Today we're going to talk you through how to create and manage your application with Google App Engine's admin console. You can get started with Google App Engine with any Google account or Google Apps for your domain account. Go to appengine.google.com and sign in with your account. If this is the first time you've signed in, you'll be asked to verify your account via SMS. But because I've already done that, I can go ahead and sign in and create an application. The first thing you'll be asked to do is choose an application identifier. This is the unique string that identifies your application in our system. You can check the availability just by clicking on the button. Next, go ahead and enter your application's title. Here you also have the option to set your application's authentication options. By default, we've selected Google Accounts, but if you have a Google Apps for your domain, you can also set your application to authenticate against accounts from that domain. Just click the Edit button, click Restrict to the following Google Apps domain, and enter your domain information. However, for this demonstration, we're just going to go back to Google Accounts since this is the default. Then, accept the terms of service and click Save. As you can see, your application was registered successfully. Just put the app ID in your app.yaml file when you upload your application. Because the application we just created doesn't have any data, now I'm going to show you how to manage an application with an existing application, App Gallery. When we click on the app ID, we'll be taken to the application's dashboard. This is an overview of all of the system traffic information. The first graph that we see is related to the application's traffic. It shows the requests per second over a 24-hour window. We can also select the dropdown to see what other graphs are available. As you can see, we can also see the number of errors we receive, as well as the number of megacycles used and quota denials our application has received. Just select the desired graph to bring it up. The next section is our application quotas. Here we can see an overview of all of the system resources we've used with respect to the free limits set by App Engine. Let's scroll down to look at the information related to each of our application's handlers. The first table we see is the current load table. This gives a breakdown of all of the handlers of our application that have been visited since midnight. We see the name of the handler on the left, and on the right we see columns related to the resource usage. For each handler, the first thing we see is the request rate for that handler. Then we see the total number of requests that application handler has received since midnight. The next thing we see is the average CPU consumed by that handler over the past hour. And finally, we see the percentage CPU that handler has consumed since midnight. The table on the right shows our most errorful handlers. On the left-hand side, we see the handler name. Then we see the total number of errors it has received since midnight, as well as the percentage of requests to that handler that have received errors. This is all of the information that's available to you on the dashboard page. Next, we can look at our logs to see more in-depth reporting for each of our requests. Just click on the logs link on the left-hand side. By default, we show all of the requests to your application that have resulted in an error. But we also allow you to filter on different severities. Just click on the dropdown to choose the appropriate level of filtering. Let's go back to the error logs. Here we see the 20 most recent requests that resulted in an error. If we want to see more information about the request, we just click on that line. This expands the section and gives us more in-depth reporting as to the error we received. As you can see, in addition to the information that we received about the error, we also provide some information about the amount of CPU resources this request has consumed. Also remember that you can download your logs using appconfig.py and analyze them offline. Next, let's look at the information available in our data store section. If we click on the index link, we can see the status of all of the indexes that we've specified in our index.yaml file. Next, we can go to the data viewer to see the information stored in our application's data store. When we click on the data viewer, we can see the information in the data viewer either by kind or by querying. Let's look at our dropdown to see what kind of kinds we've specified in our application. We can also click into an individual entity to see information related to that entity. If we want to look for a specific entity, we can do a GQL query. Just click on the query button and enter your GQL query. When you run the query, the results will be returned. In the admin console, you can also administer all of your application settings. If we click on the application settings link, we have the ability to change the application title. The next thing we can do is add new administrators to our application by clicking on the developers link. When you add new developers to your application, they have full administrative power over that application. Simply type in a valid Google account and click the invite link. This will send an email to the developer asking them to accept your invitation. Once the developer accepts your invitation to administer your application, their status will move from pending to active. In order for the new developer to have full administrative powers, you'll need to redeploy your application. With Google App Engine, we allow you to set major versions for your application. You can manage these major versions by clicking on the versions link. Whenever you upload an application with a new major version, that version will appear on this screen. The default version of your application is what your users will see when they hit your URL. But if you'd like to see your code running in production and aren't quite ready to make it live, you can also view other versions of your application by clicking on the link next to the version number. When you click on this link, this will take you to that version of the application. Non-active versions are only available through clicking on this link. Once you're ready to make a version default, simply click next to the version number and click the Make Default button. This version is now the version your users will see when they visit your URL. Finally, with Google App Engine, if you do not want to serve your application off the appspot.com domain, you can add your own Google Apps domain. Simply click on the Add Domain button. This will ask you to enter a domain name. Click on the Add Domain button, and you'll be taken to your Google Apps login page. Sign in with an administrator account. Here, after accepting the terms of service, enter the subdomain where you wish to serve the application, and click Activate This Service. Your application will now be served off of this subdomain. And that's really all there is to it. For more information, visit appengine.google.com. Thanks for watching!